So the t-test can be used to compare two groups, and it does so by using an assumption of normality. But what if we want to compare three or more groups? Or what if we're not comfortable making assumptions about normal distributions? Well, if we want to compare three groups or four groups or five groups or many groups, we can use analysis of variance. This is the next topic. And when we finish analysis of variance, we'll discuss non-parametric statistics. But just before we make that step, let's just remind ourselves that we already looked at some situations where a log transformation or another transformation can be helpful. If we don't want to make a transformation and then assume normality about transformed data, we'll use non-parametric methods. But next up is analysis of variance. And this is a situation where I have k different groups, and again I assume normality in each of these, so I compute k different sample means and k different sample variances. I want to do only one test. So I could use the t-test comparing group 1 and 2, group 5 and 4, group 3 and 8, and so on, and that would give me many, many, many tests, and this is not what I want. So I look at a situation where I have five groups. This could be the Tanner groups, or I could have three groups, or I could have eight groups, but let's think about five groups so we can use it in the data set with the Tanner groups. I assume that each of these groups has a mean, and then there's some variation around the mean, and that's described by a normal distribution. The null hypothesis is that the k-means are the same. So in the case of the data with the Tanner groups, that would be the five means, one in each Tanner group, is the same. The name analysis of variance just means that we use the variances to do our calculations. It doesn't mean that we are interested in the variances. Our focus is still on the means and whether or not they are the same. So the idea is to take the variation in the data and then look at it and say, well, some of this variation is variation within the groups, some of this variation is variation between the groups. The illustration I put in here seems to have that the total variation consists of 50% of variation between the groups and 50% of variation within the groups, but in some situations variations between the group may account for a lot, in other situations it may account for very little. And we'll use this to decide whether we reject the null hypothesis or we do not reject the null hypothesis. So we use some calculations to calculate the sum of squared deviations. It turns out that we can write up this formula. And if the variance between the groups is large compared to the variance within the groups, we reject the null hypothesis. This is illustrated in this picture here. Over here, I will reject the null hypothesis, while over here, I will not reject the null hypothesis. Mathematically, this is done using an F-test. So I take the sum of squared deviations, I standardize them, and I form a ratio. And if the ratio is far away from 1, if it's above 1 and it's far away from 1, I reject the null hypothesis. Again, these are just calculations that I make. And then if the null hypothesis is true, I know the distribution. So to perform ANOVA in SAS, I will do the following steps. I will use PROC ANOVA. Later on we'll talk about using PROC GLM, which is more general. I will put in a model statement saying what is described by what. So in this situation the model statement says that log transformed SIGF1 is described by Tanner group, and then I tell SAS that Tanner is a grouping variable, and this is done using a class statement. When I run this program, the output has six different parts: the class levels, the number of observations, the overall ANOVA, the fit statistics, and something called the ANOVA model, ANOVA, and then some box plots. So the class levels are here, and in this situation it tells me there were five groups and the values of the grouping variable was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. the ANOVA gives me the F test, and in this situation the F value is very large and the P value is very small, so we know to reject the null hypothesis. And then the graphical output is very useful, because here I see box plots of the outcome variable, the log transformed SIGF1, and I have the F test and P value up here. An alternative is to use PROC GLM. PROC GLM is more general, and we'll use this later on.